It's probably time to replace the battery in your iPhone 14 or 14 Plus, but the good news is, you can do it yourself and it won't take you too long. To do this repair, you'll need a hairdryer, heat gun, or eye opener, a P2 pentalobe driver, a Y000 driver, some iFixit opening picks, an anti-clamp or suction handle, tweezers, and a spudger. You'll also need your replacement battery, replacement rear panel adhesive, and we recommend having a magnetic FixMat on hand to help keep you organized during your repair. Head on over to iFixit.com and pick up your iPhone 14 or 14 Plus battery fix kit. And while you're there, bookmark the step-by-step guide so that you can follow it when you do your repair. It has the most updated repair procedures and helpful tips from people who have done the repair. Before you begin your repair, discharge the battery to below 25% before disassembling your device. This reduces the risk of fire if the battery is accidentally damaged during the repair. Start by powering off your iPhone and then grab a P2 pentalobe driver and take out the two screws on the bottom edge of the phone. Now let's prep your opening tool. Measure 3 millimeters from the tip of your pick and mark it with a permanent marker. This will give you a guide to prevent poking too deep into your phone and damaging something. Use a hairdryer or a heat gun to warm the bottom edge of the phone for about 90 seconds until it's just too hot to touch. Make sure not to hold the heat gun in one spot for too long, keep it moving. Place the suction handle near the bottom edge of the phone and pull up steadily to make a gap, and then slide in your opening pick, leaving it in place. It might take a bit of effort, and that's normal. Reheat the area if needed, and gently wiggle the glass to help loosen the adhesive. Once the bottom edge is loose, move on to the right side of the phone. Warm it up in the same way, about 90 seconds of heat until it's hot but not scalding. Now slide your pick around the bottom right corner of the phone and up the right edge, slicing the adhesive underneath. Keep the pick shallow, no more than 3 millimeters deep, and take extra care near the volume button. There's a delicate cable located there, so avoid using your pick in the highlighted section. Now heat the top edge for 90 seconds and slide your pick in from the top right corner and work your way across. Be extra gentle around the camera array as it can be easily damaged. Finally, slide your pick down the left side of the phone, making sure not to insert it more than the 3 millimeter mark. Remove the suction handle and swing the rear glass open from the left like the cover of a book. But be careful, there's a short cable still attached. Prop the glass up with something like a box, or if you don't have a box handy, your suction handle can work for that too. Use a Y000 driver to remove the two screws holding down the battery connector cover, then use your tweezers to lift and slide the cover out. Use a spudger to gently pry the battery connector straight up. Try not to damage the black silicone seal, it helps keep dust and water out. Once disconnected, bend the cable slightly away to keep it from reconnecting. Remove the single screw holding the charging connector cable bracket, and then lift the bracket out with tweezers. Use your spudger again to pop the charging coil connector out of its socket. Now you can take off the rear glass completely. There are two pull tabs at the top edge of the battery. These are stretch release adhesive strips. Pull them out properly, and they'll let the battery go without a fight. Peel up the first tab and slowly stretch it out. Keep steady tension without yanking it, and then repeat the process for the second strip. If the strip breaks, don't panic. You can retrieve it with tweezers and keep going. If your strips break and the battery won't budge, drip a few drops of 90% or higher isopropyl alcohol under it and wait a minute. Then gently pry up with a pick or the flat end of your spudger. Never force it and never puncture the battery. With those strips out, remove the battery. Clean up any leftover alcohol and prep the area for your new battery. Remove the adhesive liners from the new battery and gently set it into place. Press down firmly, but not too hard, so it's seated nicely. Carefully press the battery connector back into its socket, making sure it's lined up and you're pressing straight down, not at an angle. This is a great time to clean and reapply new adhesive if you'll be reusing your rear panel during reassembly. Slide the battery connector cover into place, catching the top latch first. Then, screw in the two screws securing it using your Y000 driver. Press the charging coil cable connector straight back into its socket. You should feel a little click. Now use tweezers to place the small charging coil bracket back in its spot and reinstall the tiny screw that holds it in place. It's a good idea to power on your phone briefly at this point to check and make sure everything's working. Just be sure to turn it off again before you seal your phone shut. Before you shut your phone, be sure to remove all the new adhesive liners. Now swing the rear glass back down like closing a book cover. Start by aligning the top edge and its clips, pressing gently along the edges until everything clicks into place. If it doesn't close easily, double check the clips for damage or misalignment. Grab your P2 driver and screw in the two pentalobe screws at the bottom of the phone. These are the ones by the charging port. On iOS 17.6 or earlier, your iPhone may display a warning about the genuineness of the battery after the repair, even when using original Apple parts. If your iPhone functions normally, you can safely ignore the warning. On iOS 18 and newer, authenticate your new battery using Apple's Repair Assistant. And that's it. Your iPhone 14 is now ready for a fresh start with a new battery.